My heartfelt welcome to Professor Anita HS, Registrar Evaluation, who always showed her interest in associating herself by giving valuable guidance to the department for conducting these type of programs. Ma'am, I welcome you on behalf of the department as well as on my own behalf.
Thank you.
I'm very much happy to welcome Madam Srimati Priyanka, Finance Officer, Davanagere University, Davanagere. Madam, I welcome you.
On the whole world. I would like to quote our Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi, who around 3 years back talked about this idea of human values. And I quote him, "India is that country which has always played a constructive role in the world arena. We have not weighed our policy towards any country on profit or loss, but have viewed it from the prism of human values." So this is what India is known for over the centuries. And when we analyze why ethics and why human values are important, we can make what we call force field analysis of the society. Now we can observe that there are two types of forces influencing human society and the nations and the world. First is the growth facilitating. Second is growth inhibiting. Another is synergy. First is synergy creating. And another one is nagarjee creating. Nagarjee stands for negative energy. First is conflict dissolving. And another is conflict enhancing. First is stabilizing and another is destabilizing. And first is entropy reducing and the second is entropy creating. First creates virtuous spirals and the second creates vicious spirals. First leads to forward movement and the second one leads to downward movement. So we can all see these around all of us. Now, in order to create a transformation use to positive values or to create synergy in the institutions and organizations, you need certain basic human values. So again, when we look at the question of why human values, I would like to present what I call the virus analysis. So if you look at what are the kind of different viruses influencing the human society and nations and the world, then you can identify the negative values or negative forces. So what we need is an antivirus solution. So antivirus solution will remove the virus and create positivity within the institutions and organizations. So human values represent that antivirus solutions. If you look at the conceptual foundations of human values, we can trace it from the idea of Darwinism, which is survival of the fittest, to humanism, where you take care of the other human beings, to integral model of human existence. So 4G model, G1 stands for greed, G2 stands for goodness, G3 stands for godness, and G4 stands for greatness. So the greed, as you know, the consequences of greed are creating a lot of negative energy in the organizations and in the society. Shift from greed to goodness means we are developing human qualities among the human beings in the society. And shift to G3, which is godness, means we are not only developing human qualities, but also developing spiritual qualities. And shift to greatness, for example, Gandhi and many others in the human history represent the greatness. So that means you are even going beyond what we call eternal qualities. Now, when What I call the four flowers metaphor. The flower number one is the cactus. So cactus, as you know, represents the lot of thorns. So that represents the negative values. Then the second flower is the rose. Rose also has some thorns, but by and large, you can very easily remove those thorns and use the flowers to present it to others or to prepare a garland. So they represent the humanistic values. Then the third flower is the tulip. So tulip represents what we call the spiritual values. And the fourth flower is the lotus. Lotus is a symbol of enlightenment. So these four flowers give us a very simple way of understanding the idea of human values, that we need to shift the society from the cactus to the rose, to the tulip, and ultimately to the lotus. So these are the basic ideas about the idea of human values. And today we can recognize its importance within institutions, within universities, within educational colleges, and within society, and within the corporate world, in the business world, and also in the political domain. So thank you very much for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you very much. Thank you for your insight about human values with very good practical examples. So we cannot become what we want by remaining what we are. We need to adopt some changes. We need to go for development for the future of our life in a proper way. With this, I now request Dr. Gayatri Devaraja, Registrar, Dang University, Dangere, to speak a few words on this occasion. Over to you, ma'am.
Elrigu namaskara. Good morning, everybody. Most respected Honorable Visionary Vice Chancellor, Professor S.V. Halsey, sir. Today's keynote speaker, Dr. Subhash Sharma, Dean, Indus Business Academy, Bangalore. Registrar Evaluation, Dr. Anita Madam. Finance Officer, Priyanka Madam. Dean, Faculty of Commerce and Management, Dr. J.K. Raju. Department Head, Chairperson, Dr. Srinivas, and the Organizing Secretary of the present program, Dr. Satyanarayana, and all the faculty members of the Department of Studies in Commerce. I heartily congratulate the department and the organizer for having been organized AACT and Learning Academy sponsored 5 days faculty development program on applications of artificial intelligence in business. A wide gathering and highly relevant topic that the organizers have chosen. As we are well aware that artificial intelligence is used in business applications, including automation, data analytics, and natural language processing. In connection with various industries, artificial intelligence is streamlining the operations and improving the efficiency of industrial processes. Data analytics provides business and insights that has never thought before, somewhere 5 years before. Natural language processing allows intelligence search engines and somewhat chatbots and better accessibility for people who are even visually impaired. As I understand, artificial intelligence is having its own niche across medical, health sector, biotechnological sector, life sciences, and even in business, and even in culture, language transfer, and other things. Artificial intelligence is used in business sector, which help in transferring and cross-referring data and updating file, They also forecast the consumer behavior and also fraud detection in cybersecurity. That is also another part of importance. And then personalized advertising and marketing and other customer services likewise. There are various sectors where the artificial intelligence is in applications. In addition to this, for the business development also, this is that the artificial intelligence has been used. So for a 5 days long program, different experts from different area have been invited by the organizers. And I wish this program a great success and carry home the message for the practical applications of artificial intelligence in their future business. I thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity and all the best for the rest of the 5 days and achieve great success. Thank you one and all for your kind attention. Jai Hind, Jai Karnataka.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you for your wishes and the inspirational words. Thank you very much. I now request Dr. Anita Hecker, Registrar Evaluation, Dangere University, Dangere, to solicit her views on the occasion. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you. Hope I am audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Good morning to everyone. Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Sharanappa V. Halsesar. Today's keynote speaker, my well-wisher, Dr. Subhash Sharmaji, Registrar Professor Gayatri Madam, Finance Officer Srimati Priyanka Madam, respected syndicate members, Dean Professor J.K. Raju, Chairman of our Commerce Department, Dr. Srinivas K.T., Coordinator of this FDP program, Dr. Satyanarayan, my colleagues, Professor Lakshman, Dr. Sirappa, Dr. Supriya, and all other colleagues and all the participants. I basically appreciate the efforts of Dr. Satyanarayan in initiating this 5-day FDP program. Today, the business world stands in a critical juncture. We are staring at the crossroads of transition from a traditionally run world to a modern age of endless opportunities. And every walk of human life is getting more complicated and fast-paced. Business processes in the 21st century, and especially in the post-COVID era, are getting more complex, challenging, and even beyond mere human efforts to be carried out. The staggering amount of information is out of an individual to process. With ever-widening markets, rising customer needs and expectations, it's imperative to add a digital touch to our businesses. To survive and thrive in such a hostile environment, man has befriended technology, which is what we call artificial intelligence or AI. This artificial intelligence in business simply involves the use of intelligent computer software with human-like capabilities. Artificial intelligence finds innumerable applications in the business, such as data analytics, automation, customer relationship management, and are heavily dependent on AI. Integration of AI with machine learning capabilities offers a plethora of opportunities for business globally. AI also seamlessly does operations concerning personalization and target marketing, product planning, predictive analysis, segmentation, cybersecurity, and that too in a so many spheres of business operations such as e-commerce, business management, marketing, and even business decision making. The potential benefits of artificial intelligence are immense. Artificial intelligence offers models for accurate forecasting. It also helps to boost revenues, improve customer satisfaction, increase productivity and efficiency, and drive business growth and transformation. Contrary to fears of job losses, the World Economic Forum estimates that artificial intelligence will display 85 million jobs and create 97 million new jobs across 26 countries by 2025. It is simply impossible to measure the future potential, I can say, of artificial intelligence. We can only say that artificial intelligence gives humanity the power to design our future, and the journey ahead is long and breathtaking. In this regard, this online faculty development program on applications of artificial intelligence in business, organized by the Department of Studies in Commerce of our esteemed university, is highly commendable. I'm sure this event shall illuminate our minds about truly endless possibilities of AI in the realm of business. Let the benefits of this program be percolated to all the stakeholders, both academicians and industry experts have been invited, and definitely it will help all. I wish the whole program a grand success. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your illuminative and impelling words, and thank you for your best wishes. I now request Mrs. Priyanka D, Finance Officer, Dangi University, Dangare, to speak a few words on this occasion. Over to you, ma'am.
Maybe she's not joined, ma'am. You can ask Dean, sir, please.
I now request Dr. J.K. Raju, Dean, Faculty of Commerce and Management, Dangi University, Dangare, to express his views on this occasion. Over to you, sir.
Okay. Nirku Namaskara. Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Good morning, everybody. Respected Vice Chancellor, respected registrars, respected finance officer, and today's chief guest, Subha Sharma, sir. Chairman and other faculty members of Commerce Department, research scholars, and my dear students. First, I would like to congratulate Satyanarayana and Srinivas and the team for arranging this kind of faculty development program. And it's a wonderful program. And this is an emerging title. So on behalf of myself, hearty congratulations to Satyanarayana and Srinivas and the team. Today, artificial intelligence is emerging, and it plays a major role in the world. Many people wondering today about the application of this artificial intelligence. You know, today, with the help of a computer, with the help of robots and other machines, what human beings are doing with more efficiency, more accuracy, these machines and robots are doing today in healthcare, in hospitality, in businesses, banking and financial services, and in military, wherever you go, artificial intelligence follows. So in that way, today it covers all aspects of our human life. And today many courses also offering, and our Indian students, they are going to foreign countries to study this artificial intelligence because of the scope of that course. And in India also, some reputed institutes offering, and it takes some time to cover all the universities and other institutes. So today we know in hotel, dosa preparation from robots, and same accuracy, same kind of a taste. Human can change the taste, but robots are not changing. And robots are doing operations with more accuracy. And you can do number of operations with that robot. As a human being, he can operate 5 cases per day or 10 cases per day. But with the help of robots, without stopping 24/7, you can operate. So that kind of accuracy and that kind of a role, this artificial intelligence is playing. If you check in online, if you type any two letters, suddenly in Google, it says whether you are checking this one, can I help you, like that. So it guides you to the maximum extent. So in this way, artificial intelligence covers almost all parts of our human life. So here, there is a system called it act according to the situation. Actually, that artificial intelligence is from human being only. They develop a software and that software works. But today the situation is the artificial intelligence, the robots or machines, they think according to the situation. Here only thing is some addition of human emotion. Other than that, everything is possible. They take decision wiser than the human being. According to some expert, after 15 to 20 years, the artificial intelligence strength or confidence or solutions are more than the world population human mind strength. It means it is overtaking the human beings. And my concern in this workshop are 5 days, the experts discussion on banking, finance, production, and other activities. But my curiosity and concern is there any impact on teaching profession? So we are all teachers. After 15, 20 years, artificial intelligence plays a major role, and that took the position of all teachers. Then what about the teachers? How it affect our teaching, learning, and other activities? So my curiosity is this one. So I hope this topic will be discussed in the workshop. And with this, I congratulate once again. Thank you for giving this opportunity. Thank you. Thank you one and all.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for your impressive and meaningful words, and thank you for your wishes. Hopefully, we get our answer for your curious questions also. I now take the honor and privilege to request our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Sharma for V. Harse, sir, to give his presidential remark. Sir, over to you, sir.
Good morning to all. Davangere University Department of Studies in Commerce, with the sponsorship of AICT Training and Learning Academy, organized online faculty development program, Applications of Artificial Intelligence in Business. The chief guest of this program, Dr. Subhash Sharma Ji, Dean, Indian Business Academy, Bangalore. All the syndicate members, academic council members, Dean of the Commerce and Management Faculty, Dr. J.K. Raju, Registrar Professor Gayatri Devaraj Madam, Professor Anita H.S. Madam, Registrar Evaluation, Finance Officer Priyanka Madam, Convener of this program, Dr. Srinivas K.T., Chairman, Department of Studies in Commerce, Coordinator Dr. Satyanarayan, Organizing Committee Members, Professor Lakshman P., Dr. Supriya, Dr. Sirappa, Dr. Rashmi, Dr. Sharanraj, Satish R.K., Arun Kumar, Shashidhar Kumar, and Usha, all invitees, all those who have joined for this online program. The topic chosen for this program is very important, and it plays a very pivotal role in the human society. The applications of artificial intelligence are plenty. Already our Professor J.K. Raju, Madam Gayatri, Madam Anita Madam, and speaker Dr. Subhash Chandra Sharmaji spoke about the number of applications. It is artificial intelligence. It is nearing to the human brain. It is acting as a human brain. Means it is very, very near. The errors are very, very small errors. Means whatever the human brain is doing according to the situation, we are acting. That is a situation-based action. That is why this is playing very important role in our society, in our life. So these topics, what we have selected for the application of artificial intelligence in the business, to provide an introduction of the theoretical aspects of the artificial intelligence, its applications in business, it is also very good. And to orient the contribution of artificial intelligence in the field of accounting and finance, to provide an understanding of impact of artificial intelligence on future of work and organization, to train the trainers for effective hands-on delivery of distributive technology in the field of business discipline. I think these 5 days, you get more ideas, more knowledge about the artificial intelligence. I think we are using artificial intelligence in the every walk of life today's, because today is a technology era. There is a lot of change in the technology. It is as good as we can say sea change in the technology. And now you can see in the business, in the every walk of life, already we can say the in the medical field, all in the business field, all in the even in the day-to-day activities, it is ruling in artificial intelligence as like a human. I first of all congratulate the Department of Commerce Chairman Dr. Srinivas, head of the Department of Commerce, and I congratulate the team of the Commerce Department, faculty of the Commerce, and this is a very good topic for all of us, and we can even science students also we can learn more of artificial intelligence, because it is we can use for this artificial intelligence for the process control application, any process control. Now we can say in the process control application, DC motor control is there, AC motor control is there, in all the industry application it plays a very important role. I think you know, cement industry and any that steel industries, it is playing very important role, and it is as good as acting as a human, and it accuracy is more compared to the human brain. That is why now we are using artificial intelligence, and what the professor J.K. Raju told regarding it is replacing that is everywhere, every place, what the human brain is doing. And actually in future it may actually act as a teacher, but the teacher has a emotional and it has no emotion, and acting only the as a machine. And robotics, we are using all in the robots also, we are using artificial intelligence. Even in the rocket launching, I think you know very well about the rocket launching. To launch the rocket, we are using artificial intelligence. That is, if you hit the target to particular the location, we are using this artificial intelligence. And I think you know very well about the Naval Research Board, what they are using, using artificial intelligence. We can calculate the depth of the sea using the sonar signals. We can say so many applications are there in the business. You can use this for day-to-day activities and business activities. It will be helpful to our researchers, our faculties, our all faculty members. This will be helpful, this program. And I hope this will be helpful to all researchers, those who have joined for this program. And best wishes to one and all. I thank one and all for giving me an opportunity. Jai Hind, Jai Karnataka.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for your awakening and motivating words on the profession. And we are hopeful that we get a proper insight about the artificial intelligence in this 5 days program. I now request Dr. Srinivas KT, convener and chairman, Department of Studies in Commerce, Dongi University, Dongere, to propose a vote of thanks to all the dignitaries present here.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Respected Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Sharanappa V. L.C. sir, respected Dr. Subhash Sharma sir, Dean, Indus Business Academy, Bengaluru, respected Dr. Gayatri Devaraj Madam, Registrar Administration, Davangere University, respected Dr. Anita H.S. Madam, Registrar Evaluation, Davangere University, respected Ms. Priyanka Madam, Finance Officer, Davangere University, respected Dr. J.K. Raju sir, Dean, Faculty of Commerce and Management, syndicate, respected syndicate members, academic council members, respected professors of the university, research scholars, participants. It seems to be a great honor to propose the vote of thanks to all us, all who have helped us in organizing the online faculty development program, an application of artificial intelligence in business for 5 days. As our honorable vice chancellor and dean and other dignitaries, as they have emphasized us, so Department of Studies in Commerce, under the able leadership of our senior professors, we are looking to offer this IT courses, particularly artificial intelligence, business analytics, machine learning in the field of business or in the field of accounting in the coming days, after orienting our faculty, young faculty members of the department. First of all, I would like to thank our honorable vice chancellor, Dr. Sharanappa V. L.C. sir, for his presidential remarks. So thank you very much, sir, for mentoring us in all the events. So we are fortunate to, we are very lucky to have you, Vice Chancellor, because you keep university to conduct various events in the university. I would like to thank our eminent speaker and academician, Dr. Subhash Sharma sir, for his inaugural address, which is very much relevant, meaningful, interesting. So thank you very much, sir, for accepting our invitation out of your busy schedule and delivering the inaugural address.